back to my channel Miss Medicine. Today we will discuss about mental retardation, definition of mental retardation, classification of mental retardation, what are the causes of mental retardation, prenatal, perinatal, postnatal cause, genetic factors, biological factors, environmental factors, about syndromes, diagnosis, neurological examinations, physical examinations, imaging test, about lab diagnosis, treatment, pharmacological treatment, prevention, primary prevention, secondary prevention, and tertiary prevention. We will study all these things in this video. So let's get started. Mental retardation is also known as intellectual disability. What is mental retardation or intellectual disability? Mental retardation refers to substantial limitations in present functioning. It is characterized by significantly sub-average intellectual functioning, existing concurrently with related limitations in two or more of the following adaptive skill areas: communication, self-care, home living, social skills, community use, self-direction, health and safety, functional academics, leisure and work. Mental retardation manifests before age 18. What does it mean, substantial limitations in present functioning? It means that the person has difficulty in performing everyday activities. Related to taking care of oneself, ordinary tasks at home, work related to other adaptive skill areas, academic work is also included if the person goes to school. Next is, what's the meaning of significantly sub-average intellectual functioning? It means that the person has significantly below average intelligence. The person has difficulty to learn, solve problems, accumulate knowledge, and adapt to new situations. However, sub-average intellectual function can change. Next is limitations in the adaptive skills or behavior. It means that the person with mental retardation failed to meet the standards of personal independence and social responsibility expected of their chronological age and cultural group. Adaptive skills are assessed by means of standardized adaptive behavioral scales. Next is related limitations in the adaptive skill areas. What does it mean? It means that the person has difficulty in performing the following tasks like communication, self-care, home living, community use, social skills, self-direction, health and safety, functional academics, leisure and work. Next is mental retardation is a developmental disability. It is important that the person must meet all three of the above criteria, thus has an IQ score below 70 or 75 is not sufficient to classify a person as with mental retardation. Intellectual disability. What are the classifications of mental retardation? Mental retardation classified by four types: mild mental retardation, moderate mental retardation, severe mental retardation, profound mental retardation. What are the IQ scores of this classification? Mild mental retardation, IQ score will be in between 55 to 70. Moderate mental retardation, 40 to 54. Severe mental retardation, 25 to 39. And profound mental retardation, below 25. Mild mental retardation occur in educable 6th grade, may live independently with community and social support. IQ will be 55 to 70. Next is moderate mental retardation. This patient will be trainable, work and self-care tasks can do, acquires communication skills. Patient may live and function successfully within the community. IQ score will be 40 to 54. Next is severe mental retardation. They may master very basic self-care skills and some common skills. IQ score will be 25 to 39. And profound mental retardation may develop basic self-care skills and communication skills. They need high supervision. Their IQ level below the 25. There will be four categories of mental retardation according to the intensity of needed supports. First is intermittent support. In mild mental retardation, RS needed basis, that is the person needs help only at certain periods of time, not all the time. Support will be most likely to be required during periods of transition, like moving from school to work. Next is limited supports. It will be moderate mental retardation. Are required consistently to not on daily basis. The support needed is of non-intensive nature. Next is extensive supports. Extensive supports, severe mental retardation, are needed on a regular basis. Daily supports are required in some environments, for example, daily home living tasks. Is pervasive supports for profound mental retardation are daily extensive supports, perhaps of a life-sustaining nature, required in multiple environments. Next, what are the causes of mental retardation? Are prenatal or biological before birth, perinatal during birth, and postnatal and environmental after birth. Prenatal or biological before birth, prenatal causes are those that originate during conception or pregnancy until before birth, are chromosomal disorders such as trisomy 21, Down syndrome, Klinefelter syndrome, Fragile X syndrome, Prader-Willi syndrome, phenylketonuria, and Williams syndrome. Down syndrome. The best known and well-researched biological condition which associated with mental retardation, Down syndrome, is chromosomal abnormality, trisomy 21. The 21st set is a triplet rather than a pair, which often results in the moderate level of mental retardation, correlated with the age of the mother, and can also be the result of a non-disjunction of the father's chromosome number 21. What are the characteristics of Down syndrome? Characteristics are flat, broad face, small ears and nose, upward slanting eyes, small mouth with short roof, protruding tongue, hypertonia or floppy muscles, short, sexually underdeveloped and sterile. Down syndrome children or patients will look like this. You can see flat face, short ears. Next is Klinefelter syndrome. Klinefelter syndrome more associated with the learning disability. Males are commonly affected with the Klinefelter syndrome. What are the cause of Klinefelter syndrome? Extra X chromosome result to XXY. XXY is usually caused by what is called non-disjunction. Non-disjunction happens when a pair of sex chromosomes fails to separate during egg or sperm formation, during meiosis. What are the characteristics of Klinefelter syndrome? Male sex organs are underdeveloped, unusually small testicles, sterile, has female secondary sexual characters, breast enlargement, and other feminine characteristics, less muscular bodies, wider hips, low growth of facial hairs. You can see in this picture how Klinefelter syndrome patient will look. Next is Fragile X syndrome. Fragile X syndrome or X-Fragile syndrome, most common mental retardation next to Down syndrome. It occurs both in both genders, but mainly in males. Most affected in males than females. Majority of males experience mild to moderate mental retardation in childhood, moderate to severe mental retardation in adulthood. What is the cause of Fragile X syndrome? A triplet or repeat mutation on the X chromosome, which interferes with the production of FMR1 protein, which is essential for normal functioning of brain. Most people have 29 repeats at this end of the X chromosome, but people with fragile X syndrome have over 700 repeats. The characteristics in fragile X syndrome in males: intellectual disability, large ears, long face, soft skin, large testicles, flat feet, double jointed fingers. They may also have social anxiety, poor eye contact, tactile defensiveness, ritualistic forms of greeting. And in females, milder presentation of characteristics. Fragile X syndrome patients or children will look like this. You can see in this picture. Next is Williams syndrome. It results in learning problems, attention deficit disorders, anxiety, phobias, but they have outgoing personality. It occurs equally in both male and female and in every culture. What are the causes of Williams syndrome? Williams syndrome is caused by the deletion of a portion from chromosome number 7. The deleted area includes more than 25 genes, so amount of genetic material deleted may vary. Deletion of chromosomes are due to random events that occurs in eggs or sperms from their parents. What are the characteristics of Williams syndrome? Dwarf-like features like small eye openings, broad forehead, short nose with a broad tip, full cheeks, wide mouth with full lips, and dental problems. They lack reserve towards strangers, weak in visual special skills, often hyperactive. You can see in this picture. Nose tip with little white. Next is Prader-Willi syndrome. It is a syndrome disorder which is associated with mild retardation and learning disability. Prader-Willi syndrome is caused by the deletion of a portion of chromosome number 15. May also occur if the person has a copy of chromosome 15 from the maternal side instead of each pair of the parent. What are the characteristics? In infants, floppy muscles, feeding difficulties, delayed development. In childhood, insatiable appetite that may result to chronic overeating, hyperphagia or obesity. Behavioral problems are common, impulsivity, aggressiveness, obsessive-compulsive disorders and tantrums. Another cause of PWS or Prader-Willi syndrome is translocation or mutation that inactivates that paternal chromosome 15. Characteristics will be physical features like narrow forehead, almond-shaped eyes, triangular mouth, short stature, small hands and feet. Some may have unusual fair skin and light-colored skin. Male and female affected may have underdeveloped genitals and most are also infertile. You can see in this picture, obese people. Next is phenylketonuria, PKU. PKU is inborn errors of metabolism. It is genetically inherited. A child is born without an important enzyme to break down an amino acid called phenylalanine found in dairy and protein-rich foods. What is the cause of PKU? PKU is inherited if both the mother and the father is a carrier of the defective gene. Because of the failure to break down the phenylalanine, this causes brain damage that results in aggressiveness, hyperactivity and severe mental retardation. What are the characteristics? Characteristics can be behavioral and social problems, seizures, jerking movements, hyperactivity, skin rashes, microcephaly, musty odor in the child's breath, skin or urine due to too much phenylalanine. They have fair skin and blue eyes. These are the children's with phenylketonuria. Next is cat's cry, Kridu cat syndrome. Children with cat's cry syndrome lack part of chromosome 5. They are severely retarded and show many signs often associated with chromosomal aberrations such as microcephaly, low-set ears, oblique palpebral fissures, hypertelorism, and microgynantia. The characteristic cat-like cry caused by laryngeal abnormalities that gave the syndrome its name gradually changes and disappears with increasing age. You can see Kridu cat syndrome. Next is Lasknihan syndrome. Lasknihan syndrome is a rare disorder caused by a deficiency of an enzyme involved in purine metabolism. The disorder is X-linked patients have mental retardation, microcephaly, seizures, chorioathetosis, and spasticity. Next is cranial malformation. Occurs in the developmental disorders of brain formation. Encephaly, microcephaly, and macrocephaly. Encephaly means the major portions of the brains are absent. This is a major neural tube defect, that is, it occurs in the brain or in the spinal cord. Microcephaly, the skull is small and conical. The spine is curved and typically leads to stooped portion and severe mental retardation. Hydrocephaly, blockage of cerebrospinal fluid in the cranial cavity causes an enlarged head and undue pressure on the brain. You can see encephaly, child. You can see difference between normal and encephaly in this picture. Next is microcephaly. You can see normal head size and microcephaly. Next is hydrocephaly. Mental retardation may also occur due to environmental influences like maternal malnutrition, irradiation during pregnancy, juvenile diabetes mellitus, and fetal alcohol syndrome or FAS. FAS is one of the leading causes of mental retardation. This is due to mother's excessive alcohol use during the pregnancy. Fetal alcohol effect or FAE happens due to the mother's prenatal alcohol exposure. We already discussed that. FAE is a condition associated with hyperactivity and learning problems. It is characterized by the cognitive impairment, sleep disturbances, motor dysfunctions, hyperirritability, aggression, and conduct problems. FAS incidence is higher than Down syndrome and cerebral palsy. Characteristics of FAS in children: small eye openings, smooth philtrum, and thin upper lip. You can see in this picture. Next cause is perinatal during birth mental retardation. Can be occurred by intrauterine disorders and neonatal disorders. In intrauterine disorders such as maternal anemia, premature delivery, abnormal presentation, umbilical cord accidents, and multiple gestations in the case of twins, triplets, quadruplets, and other types of multiple births. Birth trauma may result from anoxia or cutting of oxygen supply to the brain. Next is neonatal disorders such as intracranial hemorrhage, neonatal seizures, respiratory disorders, meningitis, encephalitis, head trauma at birth. Next is postnatal and environmental mental retardation. Can be head injuries, infections, demyelinating disorders, degenerative disorders, seizure disorders, and malnutrition. Head injuries like cerebral concussion, contusion, or laceration. Infections like encephalitis, meningitis, malaria, German measles, rubella. And demyelinating disorders, post-infectious disorders, post-immunization disorders. Degenerative disorders like Rett syndrome, Huntington's disease, Parkinson's disease, Seizure disorders like epilepsy, toxic metabolic disorders such as Reye's syndrome, lead or mercury poisoning, malnutrition, especially lack of proteins and calories. Environmental deprivation such as psychosocial disadvantage, child abuse and neglect, chronic social and sensory deprivation. Thought accidents, particularly vehicular accident, are the leading cause of childhood head injuries. The shaken baby syndrome, which is a type of child abuse when a crying infant is violently shaken by a frustrated caretaker, can result to head injury. This often results in internal bleeding and brain damage, and in some cases can cause death of the child. Cultural familial retardation. It refers to the existence of lowered intelligence of unknown origin, which associated with a history of mental retardation in one or more family members. Diseases of the mother during pregnancy may also result in retardation. Infections caused by sexually transmitted diseases such as syphilis, gonorrhea, AIDS, toxoplasmosis, blood poisoning, and rubella can have negative effects on the developing fetus. Maternal rubella is most likely to cause retardation, blindness, or deafness when the disease occurring during the first trimester of pregnancy. How to diagnose mental retardation? According to physical examination, the configuration and the size of the head, such as microcephaly, hydrocephalus, and Down syndrome, patient's face, hypertelorism, flat nasal bridge, prominent eyebrows, epicanthal fold, corneal opacities and retinal changes, the circumference of the head, and dermatoglyphics. Can do neurological examinations. Sensory impairments occur frequently among persons who are mentally retarded. Disturbances in motor areas are manifested abnormalities of muscle tone, spasticity or hypotonia, reflexes, hyperreflexia and involuntary movements, chorioathetosis. In older children, hyperactivity, short attention span, distractibility and a low frustration. We also can do skull x-rays. We can see craniosynthetosis, hydrocephalus and intracranial calcifications. We also can do computed tomography scans, magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, CNS pathology associated with mental retardation. We can see in CT and MRI. We can do EEG, which is best interpreted with caution in case of mental retardation. We also can do laboratory examinations, chromosomal analysis, urine and blood testing for metabolic disorders, neuroimaging. Chromosomal abnormalities are the single most common cause of mental retardation, which found in the individuals for whom a cause can be identified. We also can do hearing and speech evolutions. Speech development may be the most reliable criteria in investigating mental retardation. The commonly used methods of hearing and speech evolution, however, require the patient's cooperation and are often unreliable in several retarded persons. Prevention of mental retardation. Primary prevention, good antenatal, intranatal and postnatal care. Improve the socioeconomic status of the community, education of the public, genetic counseling to at-risk patients, syphilis and AIDS screening, vaccination of girls with rubella vaccine, avoiding consanguinal marriage, prevention measures to reduce child abuse, road traffic accident and home accidents, secondary prevention, early detection and treatment of preventable disorders, amniocentesis and medical termination of pregnancy, early detection of correctable disorders, prevention of further damage of impaired children, and tertiary prevention, treatment of physical and psychological problems by drugs, by behavioral modification, hospitalization and custodial care of severe mentally retarded or those with psychological problems, education and training of mentally retarded to avoid handicaps, make plans according to the problems and capacity of mentally retarded child. Treatment of mental retardation. Common comorbid psychiatric disorder. attention deficit or hyperactivity disorder, we will use methylphenidate, Ritalin and risperidone 1.6 mg a day for a period of 1 year. For aggression and self-injurious behavior, we use lithium and anticonvulsants. Such mental retardation persons have higher risk for the development of tardive dyskinesia. After the use of antipsychotic medications, for tardive dyskinesia, we will use risperidone and clozapine. For depressive disorders, we use SSRI, fluoxetine, paroxetine, sertraline. And explosive risk behavior, we use adrenergic receptor antagonist, beta blockers such as propranolol and antipsychotic medications. If you want to know in detail about antidepressive drugs, you can watch my video about the antidepressive drugs.